Welcome to A Joyful Noise, a concert presented by the Jubilate Chorale. This is a concert in celebration of Christmas and includes a wide variety of styles ranging from the 15th century up to the present day. Before the concert, musical director Maxine Aslin and I sat down and talked about the pieces that the chorale will be performing during this concert. Here's the first one in which we talked about the first number in the concert. The first selection in today's concert is Sing Aloud on This Day. As I recall, Max, this is an old, old tune that's been arranged by Gustav Holst.
It is. It goes way, way, way back, I think, to the 1400s or 1500s. And I just like processionals. I like sung processionals. So there's something majestic about them at Christmas. So.
And the chorales haven't, that's not a tradition with the chorale, because frequently
they have sung
that.
Before.
Yeah.
But it's always, you can imagine people who are used to singing are standing or they're seated, and now you've got them having to sing while they're moving. This can be a little on the amusing side when they first start practicing.
Well, I don't know. With a chorale that's full of people who sing in their church choirs, I think a lot of them are pretty well used to the processional
anyway.
That's
right, right, right.
And now the chorale processes to Sing Aloud on This Day. The next number on the program is My Soul Doth Praise. Now, Max, this is a little bit newer piece than the last one, coming from the 1600s. Well, Giacomo Perti was probably about 1700s when it was written.
Yeah, he was a contemporary of Bach's, and he always lived in Italy, in Bologna, in Italy. And he was very well known there, and his reputation did spread, but he wasn't really concerned about that. He was a church musician. He wrote most of his works for choirs and accompanying instruments. And he died in Bologna. He lived and died in the city he was born in.
Quite unlike some of his contemporaries who did quite a bit of traveling around.
You're right. Yeah. Yeah. And, so he stayed home.
This kind of surprised me, too, because we did the Bach Magnificat a couple of years ago.
Which was so much gigantic with several sections we call movements. This is just a very simple little, like 7 minutes, and there is no break. Yeah, there are tempo changes. It goes from fast to slow, back to fast again, but that's it.
I was really surprised at how fast we seem to go through this compared to other versions of it.
Definitely. Yeah, and this is much easier. It's more singable. I think it's has more audience appeal because it's not, well, it's just joyous, that's all. The whole thing is joyous.
Yeah, even the slower passages seem to move very nicely, and they have a nice tone.
Right,
right.
And now, My Soul Doth Praise by Giacomo Perti.
Thank you.
The next piece is The Incarnation by Lou Williams Wimberly. And this one is a much more contemporary piece than the previous two. I mean, it's like 200 years newer.
200 years newer, but it still sounds very tuneful. There's a slow part in the beginning, and then there's the fast part where you're talking about ringing bells and a volley of bells and et cetera. I had difficulty finding information about the composer. Well, I found out she had been mostly a grade school teacher, but in music. And then she conducted on the side, and she got more into conducting, and then she started composing a little bit.
And now, The Incarnation by Lou Williams Wimberly.
Thank you.
Next is one of my all-time favorite Christmas carols, In the Bleak Midwinter, composed by Gustav Holst. And this is a different arrangement of this tune.
It really is. The arranger, Abby Betaness, I found she's very unique. She found out I was doing In the Bleak Midwinter because, you know, it was ordered. And she sent me several other pieces as well. This piece has that well-known melody, In the Bleak Midwinter. And then it goes on, it has lots of oohs in it, kind of an undulating in the sections while other sections take the melody. And then near the end, it just has an almost eerie, two soloists singing that one, then the other, one, then the other, one, then the other. And then it comes back in with a final verse of that well-known melody.
That one, then the other is kind of started reflecting towards that early in the beginning when you have the sopranos and the altos alternating at snow on snow line.
Correct.
And then the tenors and the basses have a line that they go back and forth on.
I've had this piece in my library for a long time, and I thought, you know, I haven't done this melody for a long time, so I'll get it out and see what it sounds like. I fell in love with it immediately. I really liked it.
And now, In the Bleak Midwinter, with the arrangement by Abby Betaness.
Rose.
The next selection is a bit of a stylistic change. It's a Caribbean melody called The Virgin Mary Had a Baby Boy.
Arranged by somebody from Canada.
Well.
So this is, I love this. It's very, very rhythmical. And I found out that you can't sing smoothly when you do rhythmical things because it just kind of meshes together and you don't really hear the different rhythms. In one place, we've got five sections singing different things. And it's very interesting. The choir absolutely loves it because it moves right along, very active.
It's almost like a steel band from the Caribbean indeed, with all the different
indeed,
voices.
Indeed, indeed. In fact, we might have a bongo drum with us on this one.
And now, the Virgin Mary had a baby boy. The next piece is one of the chorale favorites, is the sing-along, and this one is Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Okay, ready?
Next, we feature the Jubilate Chamber Ensemble in their section of the program. The first number they're doing is called Grace.
The audience will recognize this melody also. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Except it uses entirely different words, but it uses that melody. And I think the audience will enjoy this kind of presentation. It's straightforward, not full of all things, and they sing it well. Let me tell you something about the chamber ensemble. Any small ensemble that comes out of the main group, I choose with my back toward the people who are auditioning. I know these people very well, all of them, and I do not want to know who is singing because I want to judge just on the voice and how they do it. Sometimes you look at the person and you expect something and you hear what you expect, maybe rather than what is really coming out. So all of them were chosen blind. They're given a number. The accompanist gives me the list of numbers and the names, which I don't look at until the next day. The next day, I go through my own comments with the number, and I choose who's going to be singing what. And then I look at the names, and sometimes I go, wow, I didn't expect that. So, you know, they're interesting.
And now the Jubilate Chamber Ensemble with Grace, arranged by Mark Hayes. The next piece that the chamber ensemble is going to sing is When I Lay Me Down to Sleep by James Mulholland.
This uses the words we're used to. You know, now I lay me down to sleep, I pray the Lord my soul to keep. there's never been a melody written for it, so there isn't anything to lean on or look for. So James Mulholland, who was one of the chorale's favorite composers, wrote a melody which seems to be very fitting. It's gentle, it moves in places, it repeats the melody, so that it altogether, I think we like it. I like it a lot.
Now, When I Lay Me Down to Sleep by James Mulholland. The next piece is by one of the chorale's favorite composers as well. It's The Holly and the Ivy, which is an old, old English carol, and it was arranged by John Rutter.
Oh, you say the name John Rutter to any choral conductor, and they know exactly. They can name works that he has done. And yes, he is a favorite of the chorale. I listened to this. I have this on a recording, a CD, and I listened to it. And my first impression was, how on earth are they singing this quickly? They move just like this. And I'm thinking, they probably have sung it every day. You know, it's their it was his college choir, Clare College in England. And they're so very used to singing every day that they were able to, and I use this quote, get it into their voice so that they could sing it quickly. So I'm thinking, I wonder if we can sing it this quickly. We've been working on it. We're going to get it almost up to rudder speed.
That will be interesting.
It will be.
Don't usually hear it very fast. I mean, it's a lively little tune.
It is. It is. And Rudder conducted it as the holly and the ivy when they have that is hard to wrap your tongue around all those words.
Kind of like Shakespeare in the
day. Yes.
And now, The Holly and the Ivy by John Rutter. And now the next audience sing along, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Thank you.
And now we change stylistically again, this time with the entire chorale singing Go Where I Send Thee. And this is one of the old Negro spirituals.
It is, and it was set by Andre Thomas, who is one of my favorites, because I know him. You know, I've worked with him. And he's in Florida State University, and he travels all around, conducting all around. And he does these settings of spirituals very, very well. He starts this one with a solo. And it's very, very slow, stately. And when the solo finishes, whap, the tempo changes and off we go.
And don't stop till we get to
and
the end.
And we don't stop until we hit the end.
And now, Go Where I Send Thee. And now, let us go into the house of the Lord, the next selection, written by Z. Randall Stroop, another chorale favorite.
this gentleman really is a chorale favorite. They would like to repeat several of his selections that we've done before. Can we do that again? Can we do that again? Okay. This one is conducted by one of our associate conductors. I'm very lucky to have assistance when I need it. And this is conducted by John Marafa, who is a tenor. And it's very pretty. It's not as complicated as some of the other of the composer's works. It's straightforward, probably because it's reflecting the words. There are loud places. It just seems to have a nice flow to it, not fast, not slow. It moves itself.
Yeah, it's almost a kind of a peaceful type of thing.
Yes, yes.
It's very reflective, and it's a very beautiful piece.
Yes.
And now, Let Us Go Into the House of the Lord by Z. Randall Stroop. The final selection is Sing Praises to God by Jeffrey Dana Hicks, who is somebody we actually know.
Yes. The chorale was very fortunate and in establishing a connection between Tremont Temple Baptist Church in Boston, where Jeffrey Hicks was the choir director. And every February they had a celebration of Black History Month. And one year we went, and we were the only choir that did not sing gospel. And I thought, oh, wow, how are we going to be received? And they absolutely loved us. So we went back the next year. We've gone for 3 years now. Jeffrey is a conductor. He's a composer. He also has a doctorate in ministry. So he's kind of all purpose. He has a jazz quartet that has played for Senator Kennedy. It has played for Mandela from Africa, all the while featuring people like Yo-Yo Ma, in addition to Jeffrey's jazz quartet. So he kind of is a big name in himself. But this is the first composition that I know of his. He sent it to me a couple of years ago, and I wrote back and I said, you know, I'd like to do this. And he sent back, I'd love you to do this. And I said, would you like to conduct it? And he wrote back, I'd love to conduct it. The next morning, I get another email from him. I want you to conduct it because I very seldom get to hear my own works. And he was at our rehearsal last week. And the email he wrote me afterwards, he just loved what we did with it. It's a dramatic, kind of a masterful presentation of this text. And there really is, there's one section that's medium loud, and all the rest of it is just like a march, a celebration. And it ends very, very high, which he said he got a few extra singers when he premiered it himself in Boston. And I said, well, I'm lucky. I don't have to get any singers. Mine have the high notes. So that will be ending our program, and he's our guest, so he will be present at the performance.
And finally, Sing Praises to God by Jeffrey Dana Hicks. We hope you enjoyed this concert by the Jubilate Chorale. For more information about upcoming concerts and other events, check out the website at jubilatesings.org. Thank you for watching.